मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव स्टार्टेड प्रैक्टिस सेट 17. इन दैट वी हैव सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 विच इज़ बेस्ड ऑन सप्लीमेंट्री एंगल CS. वॉट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सप्लीमेंट्री एंगल्स? इफ द सम ऑफ द मेजर ऑफ टू एंगल्स इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री देन दे आर नोन एज सप्लीमेंट्री एंगल्स. नाउ वील स्टार्ट विथ क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 फ्रॉम प्रैक्टिस सेट 17. ओके, सो दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. The measures of some angles are given below. Use them to make pairs of complementary and supplementary angles. Now here the measures of some angles are given. We will find out the pairs of complementary and pairs of supplementary angles. Yes, I hope all of you remember the definition of complementary and supplementary angles. Yes, what is the definition for complementary angles? If the sum of the measures of two angles is equal to 90 degree, then they are known as complementary angles. And if the sum of the measures of two angles is 180 degree, then they are known as supplementary angles. Okay, so now we will find out the pairs of complementary and the pairs of supplementary angles. So now we'll start. Okay, in the solution, the first pair, as you can see, I have written measure of angle B and measure of angle N. Yes, what is the measure of angle B here? 60 degree, correct. And what is the measure of angle N? That is 30 degree. So measure of angle B plus measure of angle N is equal to, means 60 degree plus 30 degree. 60 plus 30 is equal to, yes, correct, 90 degree. So hence angle B and angle N are complementary angles. Yes, this is the first pair which is complementary. Yes, measure of angle B and measure of angle N are complementary angles. Why? Because their sum is equal to 90 degree. Yes, measure of angle B is given, that is 60 degree, and measure of angle N is given, that is 30 degree. So 60 degree plus 30 degree is equal to 90 degree. So measure of angle B and measure of angle N are complementary angles. I hope you are clear with the first one. Now we will see the second pair, that is, as you can see here, measure of angle Y is equal to 90 degree and measure of angle E is equal to 0 degree. Yes, this is Y is equal to 90 degree and measure of angle E, below that only, it is 0 degree. So the pair of, or the sum of these two angles, measure of angle Y plus measure of angle E, is equal to, what is the measure of angle Y? 90 degree, correct. And what is the measure of angle E? That is 0 degree. So 90 plus 0 is equal to 90 degree, correct. So measure of angle Y and measure of angle E are complementary angles. Yes, as the sum of their angles, as the sum of the two angles, measure of angle Y and measure of angle E is equal to 90 degrees. So they are complementary angles. So these are the two pairs which makes complementary angles. I hope you are clear with the first and second one. Yes, once again we will see. Okay, so the measure of angles are given. As you can see here in the question, the measure of angles are given. You will find out the pairs of complementary and the pairs of supplementary angles. Okay, so the first pair which we have written, that is measure of angle B and measure of angle N. Yes, measure of angle B is equal to 60 degree and measure of angle N is equal to 30 degree. Yes, correct. So measure of angle B plus measure of angle N, means 60 degree plus 30 degree is equal to, correct, 90 degree. 60 plus 30 is 90 degree. So hence measure of angle B, or you can write down angle B and angle N, are complementary angles. Yes, as their sum is equal to 90 degree, so they are complementary angles. Now the second pair, that is measure of angle Y and measure of angle E. Yes, what is the measure of angle Y? It is given 90 degree in the question, as you can see here. And measure of angle E is equal to 0 degree. So 90 plus 0 is equal to 90 degree. That's why. Hence, angle Y and angle E are complementary angles. So this is the first pair and this is the second pair of complementary angles. Now we will see the next third one. I hope you are clear with the first and second. Okay, now we'll move to the next. Yes, now the third pair which is given, that is measure of angle D. As you can see here, measure of angle D and measure of angle F. What is the measure of angle D here? 75 degree. And what is the measure of angle F? That is 15 degree. Yes, which is given in the question. So measure of angle D is 75 and measure of angle F is 15 degree. So the sum of measure of angle D plus measure of angle F is equal to, as you can see here in the second step, measure of angle D plus measure of angle F is equal to, what is the measure of angle D? 75 degree. And what is the measure of angle F? That is 15 degree. So 75 plus 15 is equal to, correct, 90 degree. Therefore angle D and angle F are complementary angles. Hence angle D and angle F are complementary angles. So this is the third pair of complementary angles. Okay, I hope you are clear till here. Third one. Yes, now we'll see the next one, that is fourth one. Okay, as you can see here, the fourth pair, measure of angle B is equal to 60 degree. Yes, measure of angle B is given, that is 60 degree. And measure of angle G is equal to 120 degree. Yes, these are the two angles. First, measure of angle B is given 60 degree, and measure of angle G is given 120 degree. So measure of angle B plus measure of angle G, that is 60 plus 120 is equal to, yes, 60 plus 120 is equal to, correct, 180 degree. So hence angle B and angle G are supplementary angles. Yes, they are not complementary as their sum is equal to 180 degree. So they are supplementary angles, because in the question it is given where to write down pairs of complementary and supplementary angles. So this is the pair of supplementary angle. Which two angles? Yes, measure of angle B and measure of angle G. Yes, 60 degree plus 120 degree is equal to 180 degree. So angle B and angle G are supplementary angles. Okay, I hope you are clear with this fourth one. Now the next, that is fifth one, is, as you can see here, the fifth one, measure of angle N is equal to 30 degree, and measure of angle J is equal to 150 degree. Yes, N is given 30 degree and J is given 150 degree. So measure of angle N plus measure of angle J is equal to 30 plus 150 is equal to, yes, 30 plus 150 is equal to 180. So hence angle N and angle J are supplementary angles. So this is the pair of supplementary angles whose sum is equal to 180 degree, correct. So this is the last pair of supplementary angles. So we have seen, or we have written, the pairs of supplementary and complementary angles. I hope you are clear with this question number 2. Yes, in the question number 2, the measure of some angles are given. We need to find out the pairs of complementary and the pairs of supplementary angles. Okay, so we will see the measures. If the sum of the two angles is equal to 90 degree, then they are complementary angles. And if the sum of the two angles, if the sum of the measures of two angles is equal to 180 degree, then they are supplementary angles. So here we have written 5 pairs, 3 of them, they are complementary angles, and 2 pairs we have written of supplementary angles. I hope you are clear with question number 2. Okay. Now we will solve question number 3. Yes, as you can see here, question number 3. In triangle XYZ, measure of angle Y is equal to 90 degree. What kind of a pair do angle X and angle Z make? Yes, in triangle XYZ, measure of angle Y is equal to 90 degree. And what kind of a pair do angle x and angle z make? That we need to find out. Whether angle x and angle z, they make a complementary pair or supplementary. Now, in answer, in solution, in triangle xyz, as you can see here, in triangle xyz, measure of angle x, measure of angle y and measure of angle z is equal to 180 degree. Why? Because in a triangle, the measure or the sum of the all the three angles is equal to 180 degree. Yes. So in triangle xyz, angle x plus angle y plus angle z is equal to 180. In bracket, as you can see here, it is written angle sum property of triangle. Yes. See this. So in a triangle, the sum of the three angles is equal to 180 degrees. So angle x plus angle y plus angle z is equal to 180 degree in the first step. Okay. Now in the second step, we will put the value. Angle x we will write down as it is plus 90 degree. In place of angle y, we have written right 90 degree because it is given in the question. Measure of angle y is equal to 90 degrees. So angle x plus 90 degree plus angle z is equal to 180 degree. Okay. So in the next step, as you can see here, angle x plus angle z is equal to 90 degree. Yes. So angle x plus angle z is equal to 90 degree. This plus 90, it will go on right hand side, so it becomes minus 90. Okay. So angle x plus angle z is equal to 180 minus 90. Correct. So 180 minus 90 is equal to 90 degree. Yes, right. So angle x plus angle z is equal to 90. Why we are written here 90 degree? Because 90, this plus 90, when it will go that side, so it becomes minus 90. So 180 degree minus 90 degree. Therefore angle x plus angle z is equal to 90 degree. I hope you are clear with this step. Okay, so angle x plus angle z is equal to 90 degree. As this 90, it will go on right hand side, so it becomes minus 90. You can write down that step also. So angle x plus angle z is equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree. Therefore angle x plus angle z is equal to 90 degree, as 180 degree minus 90 degree is equal to 90 degree. Since the sum of the measure of the two angles is 90 degree, now as we got here angle x plus angle z is equal to 90 degree, hence angle x and angle z are complementary angles. Yes. Why? Because their sum is equal to 90 degrees, so they are correct complementary angles. Okay, you know the definition of complementary angles. If the sum of the measures of two angles is 90 degree, then they are known as complementary angles. So angle x plus angle z is equal to 90 degree. Okay, so that's why angle x and angle z are complementary angles. Okay, I hope you are clear with this. Question number 3. Now we'll start with next question, that is question number 4. Okay, so now question number 4. The difference between the measures of the two angles of a complementary pair is 40 degree. Find the measure of the two angles. Okay, the difference between the measures of the two angles of complementary pair is 40 degree. So we will consider now in the answer, as you can see here, we will consider first one, that is let the measure of the first angle A. Yes, you can take any other letter too. So let the measure of the first angle A. Now we are consider the first angle is A. So then the measure of the other angle A plus 40 degree. Why we are written here A plus 40 degree? Because the first angle is A, and as you can see here in the question, it is given the difference between the measures of the two angles of a complementary pair is 40 degree. So if one angle is A degree, then the second angle, it should be A plus 40 degree. Yes, because their difference is equal to 40 degree. So one angle is A, the second angle, it should be A plus 40. Correct. Now as you can see here, next step, A plus 40 is equal to 90 degree. Yes, why we are written A plus 40 is equal to 90 degree? As they are complementary pair, so their sum is equal to 90 degree, correct? And A is the measure of the first angle, yes, and the measure of the second angle is A plus 40. That's why we are written it here, A plus 40 is equal to 90 degree. I hope you are clear with this step. Yes, the difference between the measures of the two angles of a complementary pair is 40 degree. Find the measures of the two angles, okay? So first angle we have considered it as A, that's why the second angle it is A plus 40, okay? So A plus 40 is equal to 90 degree as they are complementary. So the sum of the two angles is equal to 90 degree. The measure of the first angle is A degree and the measure of the second angle is A plus 40 degree. So A plus 40 is equal to 90 degree, okay? So A plus A is equal to 2A. As you can see here, I have written here 2A is equal to 50. Now, why I have written here 50? Yes, because A plus A is equal to 2A. This plus 40, when it will go this side on right hand side, it becomes minus 40, correct? So 90 minus 40 is equal to 50, yes. So 2A is equal to 50 degree. I hope you are clear with this. 2A is equal to 50. Why I have written here 50? This plus 40, when it will go on right hand side, it becomes minus 40. So A plus A, that is 2A, is equal to 90 minus 40. Yes. So 90 minus 40 is equal to 50 degree. That's why 2A is equal to 50. So A is equal to 25 degree. 2A is equal to 50. Yes. So A is equal to 25. Why? Because if 2A is equal to 50, A is equal to 50 divided by 2. Yes, 50 divided by 2. Now we will divide 50 by 2, we will get, yes, 25. So as you can see here, A is equal to 25 degree. Yes, 2A is equal to 50. This 2 is in the form of multiplication, 2 into A. When it will go that side on right hand side, it becomes division. So A is equal to 50 divided by 2. So 50 divided by 2 is 25. That's why, or therefore, A is equal to 25 degrees. So this is the answer. Hence, the measure of the two angles are 25 degree and 65 degree. Yes, why I written here 65 degree? If the measure of the one angle is A, that is 25 degree. So what will be the measure of the other angle? Yes, 25 degree plus 40, that is 65 degrees. So the measures of the two angles are 25 degree and 65 degree. I hope you are clear with this, sir. Okay, so measure of one angle is one angle we are consider it as A, and the other angle is A plus 40. Okay, so A plus 40 is equal to 90 degree as they are complementary angles. So A plus A is equal to 2A, and this plus 40, it will go on right hand side, so it becomes minus 40. So 2A is equal to 90 minus 40, that is 50. We have written it here, 2A is equal to 50. So A is equal to 50 divided by 2, that is 50 divided by 2 is 25, correct? So A is equal to 25. If the first angle is 25, that is A is equal to 25. So what is the measure of the second angle? That is A plus 40 means 25 plus 40. Yes, do the addition, 40 plus 25. Yes, what is the answer? 65, correct. Hence, the measures of the two angles are 25 degree and 65 degree. If you want to check your answer, then you will add these two measures, 25 degree plus 65 degree. Yes, what is the sum of these two measures? 25 plus 65 is equal to 90 degree. Yes, then our answer is correct. So these are complementary angles, or this is the pair of complementary angles. One angle is 25 and the other angle is 65 degree. Okay, I hope you are clear, no doubt. So we have completed question number 2, question number 3 and question number 4. So that's all for today. We will stop till here. In the next session, we will start with question number 5. Thank you so much.